has led for some very rocky waters in terms of consumer satisfaction with the vehicle. Maybe the technology doesn't work well, maybe it does, but they don't understand it well. A lot of this comes down to either dealer training, interface design, connectivity being robust. There's so many different wheels now that are starting to impinge on the satisfaction of that car and how much I can utilize all of it within a day or two of getting it home and learning how to use it. It used to be simple, PRNDL, turn the key, turn the wheel, and use the pedals. And of course, now there's a lot more variables. So let's get some insights into how this is going to be managed and not draw down consumer satisfaction. Please welcome Renee Stevens from J.D. Powers.
Good morning, and thank you for the opportunity to be here. As Brian mentioned at J.D. Power, we spend a lot of time talking to customers and listening to customers. And what I'd like to do also is thank the audience here, because many of you have listened to customers as well, and we'll share with you the results. So what I'm going to talk about today is just some insights. We've seen a lot of great technology, but some of the insights on where are customers today, and are they on the road to autonomous? So what we're going to explore in the next few minutes here are really the automotive trends from a customer's viewpoint. This is not J.D. Power's view, this is actually the customer's. And really looking at, are they ready? What are they expecting out of the technology? Have we delivered what they've expected out of the technology? And are they building the confidence that they need in order to take those next steps and go into those fully autonomous vehicles? And then what do we need to keep in mind as an industry as we move forward into that? But before we get into all the technology, let me just take a step back and again show you where we've been and how this has come about. And really in the past, as you think about it, quality was actually a differentiator. And as we looked at probably about 20 years ago, there was a 200 to 300 problem per 100 difference between the best vehicle in the industry and the worst in the essence of quality. So people used quality to actually sell the vehicle. Those that had the best could actually use that as a selling point. Those that didn't, maybe they used styling or they put some money on the hood. But it was really a differentiator. Didn't fast forward, again, actually a lot of you that are in this room listen to the feedback that you receive from your customers on things that were wrong, things that were broken, and really you narrowed that gap and quality became more of a given as we looked at it. And over time, and there's just been some tremendous improvement in the industry, and as we looked at it, it crossed all categories. It wasn't just one area. There was really a tremendous improvement, with the exception of a couple. If you look at it, all of our multimedia, our navigation systems, and all those areas, actually those have been increasing in what we've heard from customers as reported problems. But as we look at it, it really wasn't that we were putting more failures out in the industry. It was really this concept of we're inducing all the complexity into our systems, into our components. And really as we looked at it, it was a lot of soft inadequacies in our vehicles that customers were experiencing. Things like, I don't understand how it works. I don't understand. I'm trying to get to this screen, but I don't know what screen to go to first. It wasn't intuitive. So all those types of soft inadequacies are really what we're hearing from our customers, and those have been increasing over time. And overall, what we've seen is that